Springers who are here for the first time. So to introduce everybody in this mood of what's happening here, I wanted to show our flash mob from which was made in 2019. Dim the lights, please.
Hello. Czy jest majonez?
O, jest, dobra.
This will not come back, but that's how it was. And for those of you who came here for the first time this year, I wanted to give you a glimpse of what crazy place you found yourself in. It all started in 2004. Unfortunately, we do not have photos from that time. The first family photo was made in 2006. I will not go through all the 17 years. Actually, I went through that too fast. That's the same year 2019. That was the last year when the world has not gone crazy yet. It has gone crazy a year later. Unfortunately, we could not have a normal workshop here. We had the pandemics. And then it occurred that the idea of Film Spring Open is still alive. And there were 460 active participants who took part in all sorts of courses. Natalie Portman has opened the workshop for the second time in 2020, and this is last year's photo. It's not a family photo. The last year was again post-pandemic event. We were still afraid. We had a lot of discussions between the, you know, anti-vaccination, pro-vaccination, anti-mask, pro-mask people. Of course, here we have the anti-vaxxers group. Here you can see them without the masks on their faces. Now it's not going to be fun anymore. Midway upon the journey of our life, I found myself within a forest dark, for the straightforward path had been lost. The world has gone crazy. We have found ourselves in a situation which is quite dramatic. We thought that the pandemic will end and everything will revert to normal, and now it's even worse than it was before. We thought that this war will be very short and it will be tragic. But once again in the history of the world, David is winning against the Goliath. The strength of your spirit wins over brute force. And I wanted to make you aware of that, because you, as artists, your role is to help, is to pay your dues to the world and to your viewers, to warn them, to attack, to describe. In this sense, a camera is a weapon. This weapon is as deadly and as lethal as any machine gun you can find, or as any pistol you can find, if it's used right and it's used wisely, if it will be used for the right cause. I remember a scene in my life. I was making this film. It's a long anecdote. It has a hidden metaphor. Many years ago, in order to protect bears in the Tatra Mountains in Poland, in autumn, a forestman was taking a horse to the mountains only to shoot the horse. And it was done so that the bear has food before it goes to sleep. The bear is like Russia, so it was quite a difficult situation, because bear is a symbol of Russia. It was realized at that time by a very young student of a film school. I was making film about how he made his film. I remember that scene until today. I have it in front of my eyes, when this horse, where we were supposed to shoot, of course nobody shot the horse. Well, the horse was struggling, and in one shot I had the cameraman who was shooting this, who was the protagonist of the film, and the forest man with a gun. And they were moving those two tools in unison. And then I realized that these tools are very alike. The gun and the camera, they can do a lot of good, especially the camera. But they can do a lot of evil, which is mainly what the gun does. To move on, I wanted to make you realize one very simple thing. We quite often forget about it, is that what we're working with, we who want to make films in the future, you all have to realize that your product in this factory is emotion.
Między ekranem,
between the screen and the audience hall, so you're the audience right now, if there is no emotion between those two points, this reality which you create on the screen does not exist. Emotion creates this reality. Emotion allows the people not to, makes the people stay in the cinema. It makes them people stick to the cinema and not to move to some other website. Ability to evoke emotion, ability to wake emotion is the real art of cinema. These emotions have various possibilities, transporting possibilities. I have this great feeling, like this deep feeling, that we are too accustomed to traditional methods, that it is not anymore just about pumping up emotions, that you have, that you need much bigger tools to pump up emotions, tools that reach every person in the world, and you have those tools at hands. I remember another moment of my life which also in some sort shaped me. In my hometown, Katowice, they were screening a film, very popular comedy. It was like the biggest room in Katowice was made into a cinema because everybody wanted to see that film. And I remember until today that from the park, when this huge room, audience hall was, a smiling crowd of people was descending to see the film. And I, Katowice was a gloomy town, and I saw for the first and last time in Katowice this carnival-like atmosphere which was evoked by that film. And you know the force of cinema. You know how it works. I will show you what also which also has a message. Several million people watched that. So this makes you realize that you have at your hand platforms and other tools which will enable you to achieve, to reach people, those people, without spending millions of dollars for production. You have something that generations before you did not have, and I think it's not used enough. It is also that this message should be such like that and not like this, because this message, which you can see on the screen, this also reaches millions of people, but this poisons the souls of young boys who play computer games where you shoot other people, and truth to be told, it breeds what you can see on the screen. They will also would like to smoke cigarettes and shoot Kalashnikov. This is something extremely negative, and you know it very well. The only method, however, is to build things which are as strong, as powerful, but at the same time positive. I tried to make a poster, and this is what my poster looks like. We have to build a weapon which will be emotional salvation. We have to look for these methods, and the place of such search is exactly where you are at now, where you have people of different industries, of different specialties. I will talk about that in a second, but I would like you to remember that one message from my lecture, and also to remember one thing, which I would also start with a certain anecdote. When I was preparing a film with Ridley Scott, Black Hawk Down. We finished shooting in August, and in September the two towers were destroyed by Al-Qaeda. I will come back to that anecdote again. I will tell that in another context. But it's worth to remember that the world has changed after September the 11th.
To było, była pewna
that was
cezura,
a certain turning point, which in a way
spowodowało, że powstał utwór, który to przesłanie przekazywał.
I do not remember that there would be any sort of a work of art that would express that emotion, because everybody was afraid. Before September the 11th, the world was totally different. After September the 11th, it became different. The airports, restaurants, bars, exotic places, people who were praying at the airport, all that made us afraid. Such films were not made. Great artists, of course, they are artists who should use cameras as weapons, just like Hania Polak should go around the world and should make films which require a lot of courage and a lot of insight, whether it's Iraq or Afghanistan or dump heat in Moscow suburbs, or children, homeless children living in Leningrad railway station. But there is another topic that's worth remembering about, and it's a topic which requires a lot of attention. The psychopaths who rule the world are even worse than COVID, believe me. 1% statistically of the world population are psychopaths. However, they rule us. Psychopaths are the bosses of big international companies. They're politicians. It's a synonym. A politician is a psychopath. It's somebody who turns the value of the words, and such films should be made. There should be films who attack these people directly. It can be so that in the church, regardless of denomination, they would use such slogans. All those are psychopathic characters
rządzą tym światem, niestety,
rule this world at every level, unfortunately. And it's not about those stark examples that I gave you. It is a general rule. And it's not important whether the attack is with serious dramatic abilities or whether it's attack with laughter. We have tools to shoot psychopaths, and that's what we should do. The anecdote that came up to my mind is that with the Cinebus that you've noticed probably in front of this building. We've been in Opole, and there was a strange shifty guy walking around this Cinebus, and I said to my colleagues, look out for this guy, because I think he's gonna steal something. But when I left for lunch, and he came up to me and said, I want to talk to you. I said, okay, yes, and I moved back one step, and he said, you've changed my life. What happened? What occurred? When he was a young thug, he watched a short film about killing, and that film changed his life. That's what he said, at least. Of course, it's a singular example or a singular story, but it's worth to think about it, that you have those tools and you have impacted the lives of other people, and you should not forget about that.
Tak się zaczął film, taką stronę na początku zrobiliśmy.
This is how film Spring started. We made this website and we had a short animation to start our website, and this is what it looked like.
dokładnie taka idea nam przyświecała.
And that was our idea, to work together as we, to join in the small groups. I'm still astonished today that in the world of cinema, the groups like Beatles and Rolling Stones were not created. There were many of musical bands, but I do not know the band in the cinematic world that under one common name would create something so famous and so important, to make films in groups, to and this combination is really important. Getting together is very important. I will tell about that in a while. Also, I would like to remind you that this getting together in various ways is also used by psychopaths. When I graduated from the film school in 79, I became a member of trade unions, and here it's written that proletariats of all countries should unite. My suggestion is that film springers should unite and open up to others. That was explained to me by a toucan when I was shooting a film in Ecuador. This is a message from the toucan: open up to others. And this is the place where it's worth to open up to others. Many people come here, people of various specialties, to create together. I also wanted to tell you that the age of the movies where you have one conductor will be disappearing more and more. Once they said that without a director, no movie can be made. Strangely, TV shows are being made which switch the director every week, and they have their own character, they have their own appeal. There's no need to have a director to run everything. Also, the director was necessary at some point because films, due to very complicated technology, in order to put a dolly on the rails, you needed about 10 people because it weighed around a ton. For every lamp, you needed one gaffer who was sitting on the top of a ladder and who was watching at the electrodes because when they died out, he had to change them because the light was not sufficient. The teams like this band, for example, you can see on the screen, they needed conductor. Right now, the filmmaking industry has changed totally. You can put your whole studio in your backpack, not to mention the cinebus which you see in front of the hotel. You do not need the people who say stupid things on a set. I remember this director who came enlightened to us and said, listen, I had this beautiful dream. Black is white. Black is white. And what a professional crew says, well, okay, yes, sir, you're a genius. Black is white. And then I thought, well, maybe I will take all those film that I made and I will just light them, open them up and everything will get exposed and maybe all the black will be white, all the white will be black and maybe I will get some award in Cannes. And this is not a joke because I heard the story about Kuba Morgenstern, a Polish director who went to a festival with his film and he was watching this film, his own film, and he saw that the acts were replaced by they were mixed by the operators, and he was like furious, and his film won the first prize. So his protest made no sense, because if they started to show the film in the right order, he might not have gotten the prize. The 17th edition of the FSO workshops. I put this on just because here, because during the opening, this opening lecture was to feature my grandson, who is already a very tall guy, and it's the best. It shows really how the time flies. This picture was taken during one of the first editions in Kraków, because the first few editions were made in Helin, north of Poland. And I wanted to show you what it looked like last year. This is our official making of.
I ja nie wiem, jak zrobić, żeby się sprzedało, natomiast wiem, jak zrobić, żeby mieć rozkosz.
And so yeah, this year is like each year is a very great moment. Spent here with very great team and a lot of fun, and all this equipment is just a perfect dream.
Thank you to Maxon, so we can show some of the projects that we did with their tools, and to actually meet real people and to talk to real people and feel the inspiration.
Przez te lata.
Thank you, Marta, and thank you, Slavomir. We love you. Film Spring open forever.
And I was wondering today how to describe best what Film Spring Open is about, and I came up with this idea that it's an oxytocin farm. It's a place, and that was the idea initially, that should be the place where nobody's jealous of anybody. One of the biggest vices or drawbacks and our biggest enemy to open to the to creativity is jealousy, is this tension, is struggle, is closing yourself to others. Creativity needs peace. Creativity needs time. The problem is that in our profession, you never have time. It's like a, we cannot like a writer who has a writing blog. He can put it away for a month and come back after some time. We have there's money which is given for production, and we have to spend that money in a given time. All this is a huge burden on our heads, and quite often this burden, this exactly, makes us unable to make some, to create something original. We have a tendency to do something that I will describe in a while, to repeat, to copy.
Zamykamy się i nie dostrzegamy
tego, close ourselves to others and we do not notice the thing that is important.
Czyli
and the thing that is important is our own personality. You have to answer yourself the question, who am I as an artist? What is my message to my audience? Film schools tend to forget about that. Film schools judge you. People from my generation who are over almost 80, they're judging young people who should have the right to experiment, because this is the only time in their lives where they can do it without any penalty, because nobody's waiting for them outside of the university's walls. And this is the big problem that this school causes. They do not allow you to find yourself. They do not allow you to find something, as Ridley Scott mentioned, because I made the film that I made with Ridley Scott. I was wondering, I found quite weird, and we're discussing it with our other colleagues, that many scenes in the film were about that well-hidden Americans equipped with great weapons are shooting at Somali warriors who allow themselves to be killed. That looked silly to us. We decided, those people also have some patriotism or some intelligence. Why do they allow themselves to be killed? So I finally gathered my mustered up my strength and I came up to Ridley Scott, and there was this scene when the two Americans in the wreckage of a helicopter killed about 60 local warriors. I asked him, isn't there some exaggeration? He said, I don't know, but like we have some nice scenes, because he's like a simpleton. He's a simple guy. And we completed the film, we finished the film, and a month later, the two towers were destroyed. His genius foresaw this terrorism, that there are people who are willing to die to kill other people. He could not explain that intellectually. He was not able to do that.
Just like...
As I said, that was 2019. There was no talk about pandemics. And this guy, look at his face. The pandemic started in March next year. In Film Spring, this happened in Film Spring Open. It was just having fun, but still, it has some meaning right now. It wasn't used anywhere, but if those young people follow that idea, maybe they would make something ingenious, something that would be watched by the whole world in awe. Another story about Film Spring is a very simple one. You have thousands of festivals. I remember once being a member of the Polish Film Institute, and we had the map of Poland with film festivals. In a town of Czechowice-Dziedzice, there were two film festivals. It's not far away from here. This film malady went all around the world, and this basic function which festivals had at some point, they were promoting some better movies. Now it's ceased to exist altogether, because there are too many festivals there and all the awards got devalued. What we're doing here, it's a festival of building trust, of building teams, of building something together. And as I said, with no punishment, nobody judges anybody. Nobody's looking over your shoulder. This is exactly the place where I'm trying to convince you, don't do this. I'm obsessed about this picture. I'll show it to you once again during this presentation later. My colleagues who come over here, I know, and they've been here, they know that I'm crazy about this picture. This is absurd. In Himalaya, in 1953, where Stalin died, This two people were conquered the tallest mountain in the world, Edmund Hillary and Tenzing Norgay. Went as the first humans on Mount Everest, and right now you can see people are like queuing there and people are dying in that queue. This is crazy. Why? What's the meaning of that, that you came up to the Mount Everest? And people pay thousands of dollars to stand in that queue and to be there. This is a plague, just like with the festivals. Look for your own path, look for your own means, for your own ways. And this is the place where you can try to do it. In order to find your own path, you have to find the balance between exploration and exploitation. Too often I have the feeling that young filmmakers are impatient, that they throw themselves from one idea to another. They want to do too much, they want to do everything at once. You can't do it like that. You can't do it. On one hand, it's really bad to follow the footsteps of others. I quite often give lectures, not anymore, because I'm FilmSpring is the last place where I'm really willing to come. But when I was going to film schools, I used to go to the canteen. After 5 minutes, I knew who from among those young people will be future directors and who are representatives of other professions, because these young people did not achieve anything, but they were already training their leadership ego. They had like big gestures, they were speaking in booming voice. Of course, this is not a mistake. I'm not trying to be sort of ironic or sarcastic here. It's something you need in that profession. But in a way, their mistake was that the careers such as Polański will never happen again. I'm not talking about his negative side. I'm not talking about his sexual life, but I'm talking about his professional career. Such career would never happen again. And film schools are still nurturing that idea. It's still a certain element of education. And in order to achieve anything, you really have to think, what do you want to do in your life? When I decide, really single-mindedly go there, dig deep, don't do some small holes here and there, because you will never get down to the water. Such places where you meet other people, well, and they're just filmmakers in this hotel. So like technicians, often DOPs, actors, directors, sound engineers. If you don't know a person sitting next to you, you can speak to them and you will see who you have a common topic. You can look around and you have example sitting in the second row here. Here you have like previous members who were coming here to participate, and each of them made a huge career in filmmaking. Kuba Sobek has his own production company. He's employing people, he's working with all the big gaming studios. Agata Nawrocka is a specialist in post-production. They all started here. Konrad Dziaja, he is the biggest VR company in Poland. He came up to FilmSpring when VR was not even a topic in Poland. And they found their calling here. And they're not looking for work. I mean, you can call Konrad every day. He answers only on Sundays, because that's the only time when he has time. There is a difference if you're waiting for years for your golden bullet and a person who just does the job all the time, and there are very few specialists of the second sort in the market. Obviously, a frog in a well knows nothing of the sea. That's quite obvious. And you have to look around, you have to be aware, you have to look for other places. We have about there's artificial intelligence, new media, we have a lot of lectures about that. Try, test those things for you, maybe you will find your place in there and your future. Not only the fashion changes. Technology changes all the time. You have an example of a picture created by DALL-E 2. anecdote, well, not the truth is that with the help of this, the same software, some American won a painting competition. Only when he got the first prize, he admitted that his picture was made by an artificial intelligence. This is how far it went. We have to be aware of that. We have to learn that. We have to be able to use that.
We cannot allow to
wither or to get frozen in schematics. This is the worst poison. The saddest life that you can have is the life of a person who tries all his life, and at the end of this ladder can see that this ladder was put up the wrong wall. He was going up and up and up. But at the end, there's nothing, because this is not the wall that gave him anything. One of the reasons Natalie Portman came to us is not that she left Poland, is because we managed during me and another participant of the FSO workshop, we changed her way of making films, which came at a great expenditure of energy, and she decided to give back the favor. She came here in 2015 and recorded a lecture with which she opened our remote workshop in 2020. Among others, the main topic I was talking, apart from what I was talking about this historical context and about point of view, this year the big topic is the film production, because too much money is wasted in on film sets. And thanks to the support of the Woźniak-Starak Foundation, we've managed to do a big and interesting group. The biggest Polish producers, also beginner producers, will take part in the work of that group. This will be an open group. I would like to invite every one of you to the lectures of Ewa Puszczyńska, among others. This is a person really worth listening to. She's a producer that started her career as a translator of English, and right now she has all the awards you can imagine, like Oscar nominations, a lot of festivals. Won this year again. She was a co-producer of the film of Smoczyńska. Last year and 2 years ago, the films by Wilczyński. She won everything that is really counts in Poland. This was won by Ewa Puszczyńska. She loves our workshop. She comes here every year. She got some award in Gdynia, and she fell off the stage, and she broke her leg. I was convinced she would not come, and she got a taxi and came here from Łódź to visit us here and give a lecture. That's how she likes this idea of FSO workshop. So please do not overlook that lecture and come and see her. And now practically what will happen? I have a request. I will be talking about the tutors of the groups that you see on the screen. Unfortunately, not all of them are here. They are, you know, hardworking people. Some of them will come only tomorrow. And here, at this table that you can see here, you can turn on the light, guys. We will have the persons that will represent the people who are absent. It is so that, you know, the important thing is that after this lecture, in individual places which are also marked around this building, you will be able to subscribe to individual groups. You do not have to choose one group. You can choose several groups. Two is okay, three is a bit too much. You have to remember that it's not possible to make a program in which that those groups would not be in conflict. So if you choose a group, you have to take into account that quite often you will be able to take part only in one group, because at the same time, you know, they will overlap. So this is the risk you have to remember about. There's no good solution for that. I'm really proud that we have such lecturers as we have, and the key for selecting them is very simple. We do not invite people who are of my age. We are trying to invite people who are of your age, or a bit maybe older than you, to show you that you can do it. Just like Jagoda Szelc, who made her first film, which got an award when she was already in the film school. Jagoda, who's not here with us, because I just got this message, but she will be here with us tomorrow. She will be starting her. Actually, I would like to invite the person representing Jagoda Szelc to join me at the table. Who represents Jagoda Szelc?
Hello?
Hello?
Obiecali mi, że będzie, a, wszystko
they promised
będzie działało, nie,
that
nie
there
ma,
will be a person dobrze. Who will be... Okay, I can't see that working, unfortunately.
Ursula,
is your mom there?
Światek, jest mama? Nie ma? Co?
Could you sit? We need somebody to whom people will be addressing, so sit and place that Hanna Polak. Ursula is a philosopher, so if you want to create a philosophical group, you can always subscribe to her group. Documentary film group Hanna Polak will be again with us. I'm extremely grateful to her. I would like to invite you to the stage.
Jest grupa, która tak już wspomniałem przedtem, jest jedną z mocniejszych grup.
This one, it's one of the strongest group this year. Marta Szarzyńska and Joanna Tatko will be taking care of this group. I would like to invite you to the stage. It's Piotr Starak-Woźniak Group, New Film Production Model.
I tak mówię, zaraz po wykładzie będzie zapis.
Right after this lecture, you will be able to join the groups.
Nasz przyjaciel od lat.
Our friend for many years. Whenever I see him, I feel touched. He came here 14 years ago for the first time to Poland, to the film springowy Florent Pajares.
Zapraszamy Florent.
Florent, please take the stage.
Florent robi wielkie międzynarodowe projekty.
Florent is working on huge international projects, which are extremely interesting, and I would like to encourage everybody who wants to take part to join this group. I don't know if we have Mariusz Wilczyński with us, but Tomasz Siwiński is with us, Zajks Animation Group.
Ari
Close-Up Group,
grupa, Magnus von Horn,
for the second time in FSO, he was here with his previous film many years ago, and Michał Dymek, DOP, I don't know if he's here with us. He's not here yet. I'm sorry. It's not that I'm cheeky that I did not say hello to anybody else. I just wanted to ask.
Konrad
Dziaja, VR, as I mentioned a few moments ago. Konrad Dziaja, welcome and join us on the stage.
Nie wiem, czy jest Wojtek Staroń.
I don't know if Wojciech Staroń is with us.
Jeżeli nie ma,
if
to
he's
kto
not,
reprezentuje?
Who's representing Wojciech Staroń?
To nawalanka jakaś kompletna.
It doesn't work. I don't know what to do.
Kto tam z naszych znajomych może ty usiąść i...
Who can sit here and make the subscription? Philip, sit down. Or maybe call Marta. I don't know what's happening. Marta, why isn't here anybody representing Wojciech Staroń?
Żeśmy rozmawiali o tym. Nikogo, no. No są wolontariusze, no po prostu wolontariusze.
Let's take the volunteers. And people have to address somebody to join the groups.
Muszą ludzie poznać, zobaczyć.
People have to see them, people have to understand who they're joining.
Filip, usiądź na miejscu.
Sit down.
Zamiast Wojtka Staronia.
As Wojciech Staroń.
Miśka nie nawaliła, jest. Dziękuję bardzo.
Miśka did not fail, she's here with us. Miśka, hello. Film Music Group. Magdalena Miśka Jackowska.
Wielu lat
for many, many years with
Krzysztof
us.
Ochman.
Krzysztof Ochman.
Zapraszam serdecznie.
Commercial Films Group.
Bluber Team.
Bluber Team.
Maciej Kunach.
Maciej Kunach.
Wspomniany już Kuba Sobek.
Kuba Sobek, whom I've mentioned a few moments ago.
Nie wiecie, ile telefonów muszę wykonać, żeby
you don't know how many times I have to call him to convince him to come. I don't.
Agata Nawrocka, wierna film.
Agata Nawrocka, always faithful to Film Spring Open.
Tak, widzieliście na making of, mieliśmy tutaj
as you've seen in making of, we had a group of Kędzierzawscy, SFX makeup. This year they can't come, they will be just in a lecture, and Dorota i Jakub Michnikowski will be leading the group. Can somebody sit here to represent them? One person, I need one more person, Marta, to sit in their place. All right.
Prośba, żeby zapamiętać
so please remember these faces, because right after this lecture you will be able to walk up to those people and to subscribe to the groups. And now a few words for those who are here with us for the first time. This is what it this is how it works. You got the program, which was printed, but you also have it on our website. Each creative group has its own dedicated subpage and agenda. And it's made on the run. There are people coming and going. They don't always have time. They're always trying to correlate that with other groups. So the meetings of dedicated groups have different moments, different times, and this, it all depends on the character of the group. You can see it at a dedicated website, subpage in our portal. This is where you can check what the dates look like and times. And here, there you have the information that you have not played. There's plenty of misunderstandings here about what's happening here. You have to remember that we, throughout the whole year, with a lot of effort, we make sure that the equipment is being available for you for free. Unfortunately, as it happens, we were subject to some really unnice practices for many years. We had like film groups who would come here and take our equipment and disappear. This is not for professional use. This is for only for educational purposes within the frames of the group. So we had to create a certain system of selection. So people who want to rent out the equipment, we're talking about the lighting or cameras or whatever, you have to fill in the form and address the tutor. Without the signature of a tutor or my signature, you will not get the equipment. This is extremely important that you remember about that. Also, do not keep that equipment. For example, Florence group is working during the nights, and they usually take advantage of you going to sleep, and then they take the equipment that is being returned to the storehouse. So don't hold it to yourself. If you want to take a rest, give it back to the storehouse. The warehouse will be working round the clock, almost like. They're trying not to make any breaks. You have to see that. You can see that on the doors of the store, of the storehouse. Try to use it to the maximum and do not have it lying in your room. We have a limited number, of things, but usually the equipment was sufficient. This is our experience so far. And also another thing that is, well, we're a bit we cannot add thing to this from our own money, because I can't pay for this money out of my own pocket. You have to have your own entry fee. Without the entry fee, we will not get any donation. We will not get any grants. And this is calculated at the lowest possible level. There are 2 days, maybe, like, if you have classes in audio equipment or anything, for 2 days you pay thousands of zlotys. And here you pay like a fraction of that. Please try to pay this. We have to control you this year, because we have still plenty of people who try not to pay. We still do not have enough money to pay for the grants, and we have a lot of registered people. So please remember about that, because this goes to our common good. This is a lot of hard work. We have a big team that's working around the clock. during the workshop as well as during
tak
the whole year.
Cały rok te plany robi Marta, którą przedstawię na
Marta is doing all this throughout the year. I will and me, there are two people who are doing this. I will present her to you at the end of my lecture. For those two people, it's quite a big an event. And we have to like ask people all the time and the partners for the equipment, for the money, because apart from the grants, there are like 60 technological firms. Each one of them has different requirements in a different form and the last thing I've mentioned here is the mess. There is mess here. There will be mess. We do not have like this lecture halls. We're meeting in the coffee place, in the canteen, in different rooms. This arises from certain inabilities. We cannot pay for every room that we'll be using for 2 hours a day. But this is a part of our profession. The audiovisual works are being created in a mess. Without a mess, no work of art can be created. So please do not complain for mess on mess, because you can say that Idziak made it on purpose to get you prepared for your true messy life. And what I was mentioning here already is the information that you can read again. It's an important one. You have to sign the form, which includes the conditions of equipment hire. So be quick, because there's not much time. If you want to shoot something, you have to go through that procedure. A quick information, and we're proud that every year we manage to have an interesting representation of professionals, the best films, the most discussed ones, the films starting from Agnieszka Smoczyńska, who's a director, and the producer, Hania Polak, who will be, who's subscribed for Oscar, Jagoda Szers, Damian Kocur, who got the Journalist Award, Magnus von Horn, who made his second film, and he's an example of the director who really doesn't have time. When I was in the film school, Skolimowski was one of the directors who realized that it's not worth only to study, but you have to use this time, and the fact that you're given the tape and the film team and the cameras, and he made a feature film. We were graduating, we're going out of this building, and suddenly we started to look for some sort of job, and he had a feature film under his belt for which he got an award. These are the people who do not waste time. They win. Magnus is exactly the same. He made his first film. He started the production of a film when he was at school, which then was screened in Cannes, etc. The Intruder. They are the examples of creators. They want to do something. They focus on one thing. I did not look at others, and of course it's a great place to spend time, and it's good to spend time nicely and drink beer together, but use up this time to the full in a more creative and serious way. Mariusz Wilczyński, obviously, the ingenious film, Wojciech Staran, a man of all trades, with lots of awards, Tadeusz Siwa, great movie, great musical films, Agata Buzek, who's a well-known actress, a great pantheon of producers. We have some really great surnames here with us. I omitted Mr. Terej. I'm sorry for that. I have noticed that only now. Ewa Puszczyńska, Agata Szymańska, Mariusz Włodarski, who won the award for the best producer of the year, Maria Gołoś, Monika Maturzewska, who are young producers, Alan and Wiesława Starski, set and costume designers, and Oscar for Alan Starski. They will be here with us. Michał Sobociński, who wanted to come, but he's doing a TV show right now with Juliette Binoche and some American, like some great names in Paris. Michał Dymek will also have a lecture within the frames of his group, and he was shooting the film for Skolimowski, which will be representing Poland at the Oscar Gala. Miśka, which, who spent her whole life in RMF radio station, devoting her life and professionalism to cinematography, and she's specializing in
i prawną, i jak selekcjonować movie, muzykę. Przyjdzie też Szymon
music,
Majewski, że was
and Szymon Majewski, who will cheer you up. He will be talking about promotion in the cinema.
Nowe media.
New media.
Powtarzam jeszcze raz, skupcie się na tym.
Please focus on that, because that is the future. Konrad Zjaja, Aleksander Fafua,
Sztuczna inteligencja, Jakub Ben, AI, pracownik Wiedźmina, teraz ma własną firmę, Agata Nawrocka,
on The Witcher right now, he has his own company, Agata Nawrocka, post-production, Kuba Sobek, Nikita Diakur, Cinema 4D, he will be coming especially to see you here, and
za małe środki, making up,
and SFX makeup for on tight budget, Marian Folga. So, and of course, to boot, we have a lot of equipment presentations. We have about 60 companies and distributors working with us. We are very grateful for them. At the end, I will be also talking about that. I said that I will repeat that picture again, because the success of those people is, as you can see, and this is the stench that they leave in their wake.
To są Himalaje.
This is the Himalayas, and this is after each expedition. This is how much garbage is left in the place where base camp is located at Mount Everest. And we're doing the same in the cinema. If the Earth could think, it would get rid of us. And it is getting rid of us, to be frank. So during the film spring open.
Green panel.
Workshop will also have green panel, green film opening panel for the fourth time.
Zapraszam was
and
na
I would like to invite you to take part in this, because this is a necessity. You cannot. This is something undisputable. If we are responsible people, thinking about the planet right now is something very important. All this plastic, food, this plastic being thrown all around. You drink 3 gulps of water and you throw, then you throw a plastic cup into the ocean. I live on the African island right now, and I can't surf because 300 miles away from Africa, we have garbage floating all around our island. It's incredible. Soon you will not be able to see the water, just plastics.
Nie mam żadnych wątpliwości, że przyszłość definiują współpraca między artystami i programistami. To są dwa różne rodzaje myślenia.
Na spotkaniu tych IT developers, there are two different ways of modes of thinking, but at the meeting point of those two different kinds of people, the audiovisual art is being created. We've been talking about that for many years. We managed to do that last year, thanks to the cooperation with the Wawel Castle and with local authorities. We're making hackathon for Wawel. This year, again, they're willing to do that with us. If you have any ideas of that sort, this is a very interesting domain. And this also is huge money. If you find a program of refreshing the way to visit such museums, which will bring closer to the young people who are adapted to computer games, you'll be able to tell them stories through immersion. That is a necessity. The hackathons take place only during the weekend. Remember that IT specialists do not wait for work. They have work all the time, so this is the only time when they can participate in something like this. And right now, a few last remarks. I know I've been talking for too long. Our website and our future will be evolving. I wanted to tell a few words about that. Let me start with a thing that is important, because there's no doubt that it's not enough to produce something good if you have to also promote it. This should not be promoted when we finish our work, but also, and that's what the Piotr Starak Memorial Group is doing,
świetny, jeśli chodzi o promowanie.
He was great in promoting.
Rozumiał
to, understood
że
that
jeszcze nic nie powstawało,
nothing was created yet.
Było,
there was no script yet, and he was already promoting the product. This is a necessity.
W współczesnym świecie bez promocji.
In contemporary world, we do not exist without promotion. And here we'll be trying to do something similar at the level of cooperation.
Zrobić taką wirtualną galerię,
to do a virtual gallery where you're promoting projects which are in the making. They could be at the level of moodboard or at the stage of moodboard, but something has to be already made to look for money or collaborators or maybe advice. We do have a consultancy service where, of course, for money, because those people who work there, they will not do that for free, although some do that free of charge. They can consult the problems you have with your works, because this knowledge is very broad, very wide, and this is not easy to know everything, especially when it comes to post-production. This virtual gallery is to help with it.
Kierunek zmian,
the
który chcemy osiągnąć,
direction of the changes you want to attain is
Helu.
Here you have a picture from Hel,
to było spotkanie Szwajcarów
a peninsula. It was a meeting of Germans and Swiss, 15 people around, who for the whole year were preparing a script, not knowing one another, in the internet, and then they came to Jurata, to a to like military summer camp, and they made a film together. That was a great model for Filmspring Open, but unfortunately it was so well that they started to come more and more often, and it was impossible to create such a small close-knit group. And we gradually, because nothing was developed by a revolution, we decided to come up with a more broader and richer Filmspring formula. Last year we had 26 projects during the last screening. So it's difficult to limit that to one single movie. We try to use the example of that first idea, but I mean, we have new problems we have to tackle. For example, the energy business, we have problems with heating right now, we have many other reasons. I don't want to discuss that again, that film schools are preparing you for the job of yesterday, not the job of tomorrow. We want to create a system of online audiovisual education, where those course will end up with Filmspring Open Workshop, so combination of online remote education for the whole year with a joint meeting during workshops at the end of the year. We want to propose that as individual courses and also as packages, for example, a DOP package, where in one package you have a proposal of filmmaking, technical, visual dramaturgy, visual dramaturgy, sorry. Or promotion, editing, post-production, color correction, or some basic visual effects, especially editing, because I believe that a DOP, especially if you want to be to work independently and do some smaller forms, you should also learn that. This is our future. You're invited. I already wanted to announce that Hania Polak will be conducting an audiovisual course. Mr. Siwiński will have his audiovisual course. So we're starting that already. Several courses have taken place. We have created tools for that. So if you have ideas which courses you would be interested in, please inform us about that. We would like to do something that will not be limited to these 9 days of a great meeting, but it will broadened by a more serious approach, more serious professional preparation in a form of online education. Please do not forget that we have an uptick in coronavirus. I do not, I will not try to persuade you to use masks, but I will use masks because I think, I believe you should use masks. In Germany, you have masks in public places. Please take that seriously so that your stay here does not end badly. Keep distance. I know that that there are different views, but my duty is to warn you that we're still not out of the pandemics. It is among us. So this is the last thing I wanted to say.
Were
it not for Marta Dalecka, I would like to invite her to the stage. This I will already abandon this idea because it's like hard work. It's only thanks to her that the workshop is in existence. Marta is working 7 days a week. She writes all the grant applications, she does all the settlements, she does all the calculations. We should all be very thankful to her because without her and without her hard work and her determination, nothing would work out. If you were to compare crews that are creating such events, which usually have at least 15-20 people. I mean, we do have a lot of people who cooperate with us. I don't know how many people there is, about 15 people. And I would like to thank them too, because it's the first time, if I remember, we had no problems with preparing all the infrastructure, all the equipment. All this team has been working with us for many, many years. And right now, everything is working like a clockwork. I would like to invite you personally to the stage when we will be saying goodbye. Please give them a round of applause, because during the last 2 days it was like a gigantic work. We had to put up all the projectors, the screen, we have to darken the room, set the Cinebus with the infrastructure, the networks, etc., etc. It was huge pile of work, making the inventory of the warehouse, because it's like worth millions of zlotys. They've been working round the clock for the last 72 hours.
Także bardzo, bardzo im dziękuję. No
so
i trzeba podziękować
thank,
tym, co nam
I would like to
co
thank
nas
them a lot,
pomagają.
And I would like to thank everybody who support, who's been supporting us for all those years. Without their support, nothing would happen.
Partnerów jest bardzo, bardzo
As you can
dużo,
see, we have plenty of the partners. We would like to thank them a lot for helping, and we also hope that I also hope that you will also be thankful after we finish the workshop. I can see a lot of faces, of friendly faces, and thank you. As I said, there are tables out there.
Marta, stoliki są gdzie rozstawione? Tam na zewnątrz, tak? Gdzie?
When it comes to subscription to the group, let me just add a few words. Listen. I will read out the groups. If you have decided already which groups you wanted to join, please remember the name of the room. If you do not remember, there are also posters outside with the names of the groups and the names of the rooms. Go to the rooms where we have prepared your places to subscribe. The biggest group that you will find is in the editing room. If you go outside from this room, straight up, which group is there? It's the VR group.
CGI Kuba Sobek.
Nuke Agata Nawalska.
Maciej,
and, sorry, Maciej.
Maciej, grupa gier wideo.
The video games group. They're all in the editing room up the stairs in front of this room. Ari close-up group will be in the aula, so stay here.
Grupa Florenta Pajares
group will be in the tent. He selected it himself. outside of this building.
Jak będzie wam za zimno, to zapraszam
do foyer. If it's too cold for you, please join us in the foyer at the reception. Jagoda Szelc group is already here, but if there are people willing to listen to them, join us at our office. I will be in the foyer at the reception desk, so we can add you to the group. Jagoda is not here with us yet, so please be reminded that she will be here with us tomorrow. We will be updating the website, we will find her the information in which room you will meet. New production model, Marta Szerzyńska and Joanna Tatko. You meet in the F at level minus one next to the aula on the left hand side. Hania Polak documentary group. You meet in the restaurants upstairs. Very nice. A very nice place. Animation group represented by Tomasz Siwiński. Tomasz, you are meeting in room A. Second floor. Musical video. Tomasz Siwal. He did not reach us yet, but we will tell you tomorrow where the meeting will take place. Who's next?
Grupa. Muzyki filmowej.
Film Music Group. Magdalena Miśka-Jackowska.
You will meet w sali K, pierwsze piętro.
In room K.
Chcielibyśmy.
Concert hall, maybe at some point. Maybe here in the aula next year. I just wanted to say that because in the beginning, when you entered the hotel, I wanted to tell you that it's like a living organism, this workshop. You don't know how things will happen, where these groups will end up, and how they will be moving around this building. So please follow our website closely, because we will be updating your groups every day. So if you decide to move to a different group, you will find all the information on the website. Did I forget about anyone?
Namiot, Aura, Foyer. Okay.
Sony Xperia Group. Krzysztof Ochman. You will be meeting here in front of this room. Then you can move to Foyer next to the reception desk. If you will be meeting here with Krzysztof. And did I forget about something?
Ktoś tam jeszcze...
Wojciech Staroń.
Ja będę też te zapisy zbierać.
I will be collecting the subscriptions for Wojtek Staroń's group.
Sony, tak.
The Sony group.
Do grupy Sony w foyer.
In the foyer, next to the reception desk. And that's all from me. Do you have any questions? If something is not clear,
niejasne, albo jeszcze
you forgot which room is that,
na ścianie, na naszej tablicy ogłoszeń,
just in front of the door to this room you will see a poster with the information which group meets where. Is that all?
Jak w szkole, no.
It's a bit like at school.
Okay. A jakby były jakieś pytania,
if you have any questions,
skargi, zażale,
any remarks or complaints?
Tak, charakteryzacja.
Oh, the makeup group.
Dzięki, Majo. Charakteryzacja i animacja lalkowa będzie od jutra.
And animation will start tomorrow, and that
trzecia,
will be level 3,
tam będzie już docelowo
room 305.
Cały czas ta sala. Chyba wszystko.
I think it's all.
Jakbyście potrzebowali
so if you need anything,
wiecie, że
you know
biuro
that
znajduje
the office
się po
is on the right-hand side
od wejścia
from
od
the entrance
recepcji,
and reception desk.
Także zapraszam serdecznie. So, ja z Martą tam
you're invited
dzielnie
to join us there.
Walczymy.
Me and Marta, we're ruling that kingdom. And I sent you yesterday the manual of the participants, and I would like to encourage you to look at the map of the building. So that you do not get lost, but we're always at your service if you have any problems and you were looking for any of the rooms. We will be glad to give you a hint. All this crew, for example, knows those four people from the editing room, they know this building very well, they will tell you what's where.
Okay, wszystko wiadomo?
So everybody knows everything?
Dobra, dzięki.
Thanks. Thank you. Thank you.